Welcome to DWBI Adda channel. Please subscribe for latest training videos.
Hello everyone. Welcome to the video tutorial on Seaborn. Seaborn is a Python library created for enhanced data visualization. It is a very timely and relevant tool for data professionals working today because effective data visualization and communication in general is particularly an essential skill. In this introductory session, we are going to start exploring Python Seaborn library. Let's start the session. Visualization plays an important role when we try to explore and understand data. Seaborn is aimed to make it easier. Seaborn basically a Python data visualization library based on Matplotlib. As it is built on top of Matplotlib, we will often invoke Matplotlib functions directly for simple plots. Statistical analysis is a process of understanding how variables in a dataset relates to each other and how those relationships depend on other variables. Visualization can be a core component of this process because when data are visualized properly, then the human visual system can see trends and patterns that indicate a relationship. And Seaborn is a tool for drawing attractive and informative statistical graphics. Pandas is a data analysis and manipulation module that helps us load and parse data. In Pandas, data is stored in data frames. Seaborn creates plot from Pandas data frame. NumPy, SciPy, Matplotlib and Pandas are the mandatory dependencies for Seaborn. These libraries should be available before we start our work with Seaborn. The latest version 0.10.0 was released on January 2020 and Seaborn is strictly compatible with Python 3.6 or upper version. In this section, we are going to unfold the reasons behind choosing Seaborn. Seaborn examines relationship between multiple variables. In data analysis, it is a common practice to find out the relationships between variables. Seaborn has a good number of plot functions like scatterplot, barplot or relplot to visualize these relationships. Standard scatter and line plots visualize relationship between numeric variables, but many data analysis involve categorical variables. There are several specialized plot types in Seaborn that are optimized for visualizing categorical data. We can use catplot, which generalizes over different representations of relationship between one numeric and one or more categorical variables. Seaborn has options for visualizing univariate or bivariate distributions. Suppose for univariate, we can use distplot or simple boxplot. And in case of bivariate or multivariate analysis, we can use lmplot, boxplot or simple scatterplots. Seaborn offers automatic estimation and plotting of linear regression models. Two main functions, regplot and lmplot, are used to visualize a linear relationship as determined through regression. Both the functions draw a scatterplot of two variables, x and y, and then fit the regression model y versus x and plot the resulting regression line and a 95% confidence interval for that regression. Seaborn provides high-level abstractions for structuring multi-plot grids that let us easily build complex visualization. We have two important options, facet grid and pair grid. The facet grid is useful when we want to visualize the distribution of a variable or the relationship between multiple variables separately within subset of data. Pair grid also allows us to draw a grid of small subplots using the same plot type to visualize data in each. Color is more important than other aspects of figure styles because color can reveal patterns in data if used effectively. Seaborn makes it easy to select and use color palettes that are suited to the kind of data we are working with. Seaborn offers a good variety of usable graphs. We can easily plot bar, box, violin, line, and many other plots. This is not the complete list. For the complete list, we can go to the official page of Seaborn. Let's go there. This is the complete plot gallery of Seaborn. You will get a lot of options to work with. If we select any of them, it will display the name of the plot. If we go further, it will offer us a complete example of that specific plot. In the next section, we will work with a simple example of Seaborn. Visualizing a plot using Seaborn is pretty easy. We already know that Seaborn works with Matplotlib, Pandas, SciPy and NumPy. In this Jupyter notebook, first we imported Seaborn and related libraries. In this example, we only use NumPy to generate random numbers, and Seaborn will help us to visualize an univariate distribution plot. In this section, we have generated random numbers. This displot function has created a distribution plot for X. Its default parameters help to create a well-structured graph. It is really easy to work with Seaborn, and you will love to work with it. In this final section, we will work with the built-in datasets of Seaborn. It offers a good number of standard datasets like Irish, MPG, TIPS, Titanic, and many more. In our tutorials, we will work with them very often. We can also use Pandas library to import external datasets and visualize the relationships among data. Today, in this video tutorial, we have introduced Seaborn and explained the basic reasons to work with it. That's all for today. See you in the next tutorial. Thank you very much.